Hello everybody, my name is Phaethodas, welcome to this video. Here we have this build, which is the Said set with a staff though. The staff version of the Said set, the full set with a staff. And the staff Said set Prophet build. And here I am legendary. I have started the journey from Act 1 Elos legendary difficulty. This is a legendary hero. And I have reached Hades Palace. This is Hades Palace in the beginning. The entrance of Hades Palace. And I have reached this place, and in this video we will go through Hades Palace and we will go fight Hades as well. And of course we will see if we meet any dactyls, the true big bosses of this game, you could say, in a way. Then we will see how this build can do against those enemies. The very, very interesting thing about this build is that it has -106%. -106. -57, -69, -48, -1, 157, and this number. So, the survivability numbers of the build, they suck. I mean, -106%, not even 100, but 106. Also, the average damage numbers and DPS, they suck. Everything sucks. But so far, we have died only 4 times. 4 total deaths. Despite having such bad resistances and not the best damage output out there. And one of the deaths was damage reflection. The other death was my mind was not in the game when that happened. It was from a small enemy. So yeah, anyway, only 4 deaths with such bad resistances, which proves that this build, specifically this build, a prophet with this set is very good. The prophet class for this set is perfect, because actually it is the prophet class with the skills it provides and a little bit of this one, the Lyre of Apollo with the energy drain, all this put together that give this very good performance to this character. Now let's trigger the skills, let's go fight Typhon, undead Typhon, which is the first boss of this area. I don't want to get hit by this. Okay, we can see that as long as he doesn't have any energy, we keep draining his energy all the time. Okay, this was very dangerous. Yeah. This is why. The energy drain, you drain energy of enemies and big bosses, and when they don't have energy, they cannot cast their spells on you, and this helps very much with survivability. Agamemnon's Crest, okay. Now, let's go for Hades Palace, or the rest of Hades Palace. Okay, now, I cannot hit the ancient locks, are you kidding me? Bless you, bless you. Make haste. If there are just a few... I make haste. Okay, zoom out and let's see how can this build perform in this area of the game legendary. Super great soundtrack in this area. Nice. So far so good, everything is very, very easy. And you know, these enemies hit very hard with piercing and physical damage. But we have this one physical resistance. We don't have the best pierce resistance, of course, but we have all of these skills. For example, Squall reduces the damage of enemies by a very big amount. Okay. Demonic Reapers. It is a thrown weapon. Let's see. Okay. Nothing special, I would say. Of course, I will defeat all enemies in this palace, as I always do. And I will explore all places, as I always do. This is the best way to gain XP and rewards in this game. Explore everything, kill everything, complete all side quests. Poseidon's Greaves. Nice. Let's see, is there any dactyl? No, no dactyl here. I don't think that this build will have any problems against Hades boss. Although I will have to be careful, of course. I will still have to try to avoid the spells and skills and attacks of Hades. But I don't think it will be a problem. Okay, I wanted to cast the shield on my character, not on my pet. But anyway, does it really matter? Come on, Gigantes. Oh, they are stunning me. Yeah, draining energy of enemies or at least life leeching them is awesome. It is very awesome, it is a very powerful mechanic. There is no dactyl here. Nice, but I don't see these enemies throwing any dropping. Any master frequent items today. War Disc of Sulfur, it is a green item, a rare item. Oh! Bloodborne leggings. Okay. Poison resistance. Not good. That one is a mastery frequent, but it is a leggings. It is an armor item for your legs. There is nobody there. Let's come here. Yep. I wasn't expecting any dactyl here in this, in front of this door or gate, whatever door. But a dactyl could be here actually. This is not a dactyl though. Okay, no dactyls so far. This is a good thing because dactyls can defeat me very easily. I'm talking about this bit specifically. Or maybe not. Maybe not. We will see. If we meet any dactyls, then we will find out. But I would like to meet at least one dactyl to see how this bit really performs against dactyls, because you never know. Maybe dactyl cannot really defeat this bit if I will be careful enough. Take this. Deflect it, I don't care enemy. Mastery frequent. Oh! Vitality damage, vitality damage. This is very good if you go to make a vitality damage build based on thrown weapons. I will keep this one and maybe in the future if I will think of a build with vitality damage and thrown weapons, maybe I will make one. You know, it is a mastery frequent item, which means that you can enchant it with a component. And there is at least one component in the game, which provides vitality damage on weapons. I think it provides 100 flat vitality damage on weapons. It is a charm, I don't remember the name of the charm. If you remember the name of the charm, guys, leave a comment below. Remind me, please. Yeah, stunning them, killing them. Okay, we also have to be careful against these little enemies, the spiders, because they use this type of damage. Lightning damage on you, and of course, as we saw before, my resistances are super duper bad. Let's go this way. Okay. Good news, these enemies cannot really kill me with their thrown weapon attacks. La 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 la. Come on, Giants, give us something good to drop. A good MI item. MI. There will be no dactyls in this area, but we will have one of the generals of the quest. I will have to defeat the general. And it is not just a general, there are many more enemies as well, demons. Opa. Yes. Oh, oh. Yes, you are dad. You are dad. No, you are not my dad. You are down. I wanted to say. Okay, now he doesn't have any more energy, so things are easier. What kept me alive there was the Death Ward. Where is it? Death Ward? Ah, we don't have Death Ward. Ah, yeah, Death Ward is an item of... is a skill on the staff. Death Ward, I have it. I totally forgot about Death Ward. Da-da-da-da. Okay, so far so good. Let's go. My enemies are waiting for me to kill them all. Okay, now this general here will be very tough. He has many other enemies with him, and they are also archers and whatnot. Things are not going to be easy here. Ah, okay, they died pretty quickly though. In the end it was easy. An easy battle. And here we have a Vindicator and a Giant. Okay, let's go ahead, move ahead. I have only 23 health potions and 142 energy potions. As far as I remember, I don't have any attack damage compared to health. Okay, this enemy here, the Warden, will be challenging. Or maybe not, because I will shoot him down from a distance. Like this. Ah, easy, very easy. Let's find out now. Any dactyls? Where are the dactyls hiding today? Please don't go away. There is a chest. Should I go and open up the chest here? Yeah. Okay, everybody's down. Kigley Stygian Helm of Permanence. Ta-da. We are getting very, very close to Hades boss. I still want the dactyl to come out, at least one dactyl. Oppo, I got saved there by what? By something. I cannot stand this boss. It is a minor boss, but it is a boss nevertheless. Nice. Okay, maybe it is time to go and buy some health potions before we go, or maybe. Yeah, let's go buy some health potions. So, we open up the door, we go down the stairway, and then we will fight some gigantes enemies.
Welcome.
And hopefully, maybe... a nice item. Maybe, how do you call it? Should I sell this one? A dactyl or something. 104 vitality damage. This one has 82 and 54. So this one has 136 vitality. This one has 104 vitality. So what do you do now? Do you sell this one or this one or... Yeah, sell this one. I don't know. Maybe I will decide to make a bid with that weapon. Now, let's find out the truth. Dactyl? A dactyl! A dactyl is here. So, I'm using this thing. Yeah, I'm dying. Yeah, dactyl is very hard. Wow, I forgot to pick up the soul stone. What am I doing with my life? Where is my pet? All I need to do is to drain his energy bar. If I can drain his energy bar, he is done for. I guess I am done for. I don't have very fast casting speed. This is one of the problems here. Yes, I stun him. I'm draining his... Yes. So, if he doesn't have any energy to cast his very powerful spells, he cannot really defeat me. But it is still a very, 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 very dangerous enemy for this build. And now, finally, we go for Hades boss. So, dactyls are very dangerous for this build, but if you are careful enough, you can survive, as I did. Now, let's take this thing there. 8 experience gained bonus. Elare. This is very bad. Now, Hades boss fight. Let's see. I have some scrolls. I have Scroll of Behemoth. I'm not going to use any scrolls. I will only use my pet and my dream image.
You will pay for your hubris.
Yeah, sorry god, but I was going to fight a god, and that god happened to be you. So, it is not my mistake, it is not a blasphemy. It is not madness, it is Sparta. I have to be careful. Don't go to hit by that! Yes! The Saint said with a staff, despite the super bad resistances, it survived with only 4 total deaths. The Palace of Hades was not powerful enough to defeat this build. Hell Medallion of Power, sell it, sell it. Light of Apollo, sell it. Now the question is, do I go to Corinth or do I go to the east? I will go to Corinth. So, this is it for this video, guys. It was all about going through the Palace of Hades and watching how this build can perform. Overall, it was a very, very easy run throughout the whole palace. All enemies were very easy, except of course for the Dactyls, which were very hard. Actually, the Dactyl was harder than Hades. But Hades could also have killed me very easily had I get hit multiple times by his attacks. But I was fast and smart enough to use my skills at the right times and whatnot and survive. So, this is it for now. Thanks for watching this video. I'll be back very, very, very soon with many more videos and live streams of Titan Quest and other games as well, action games and whatnot. Stay tuned, guys, with more content that is coming up. Subscribe, hit the like button if you want to support the channel. And I will see you very, very soon again. Have a good one.